HCAM programming is supported by our viewers. Thank you. And by Golden Pond Assisted Living, honoring resident choice, dignity, and independence. Our health and wellness focus keeps residents active. Golden Pond, state-of-the-art senior housing and healthcare services.
And by WPC Pest Control, a family-owned business for over 35 years. Owners Jim and Rebecca Mazzucchelli provide honesty, respect, and integrity, performing safe and effective pest control services. They service your home like it's their home. Hello, and welcome to HCAM News. Tom Nappy at the anchor desk to keep you up to date with what's happening in Hopkinton. On this edition of HCAM News, we have highlights from this past Poly Arts Festival and the Greyhound Friends open house. Razor's Edge Salon cut the ribbon on their new location, and owner of Angel's Garden Center, Jeff Doherty, will give you some tips dealing with drought conditions. But first, here are some happenings in Hopkinton you should know about, including the latest Hiller Sports highlights. The Charter Review Committee hosted a public forum at the HCAM studios to receive input and feedback from Hopkinton citizens regarding potential changes to the town's charter.
For this forum, we're not passing any type of judgment on what's happening or what has happened. What we're doing is we're offering the structure of the charter and what each section kind of covers. And we've tried to boil things down to just put something out there to start conversation and see what people's impressions are in terms of the changes you think might be necessary. As a board, we've gone through a process of getting input from all of the boards and committees in town, as well as department heads. And so we've taken that input. Now we want to get input from the rest of the public.
A second public forum will be held on December 7th at a place and time to be determined. A special town meeting to review the town's charter will be held on Monday, February 13th, 2017, at a place and time to be determined. Turning now to sports, on September 15th, Hiller's girls soccer took on Norton. A good defensive clash, but the scoring opened up a bit in the second half. Norton netted two goals and held on to win 2-1.
What a shot that was by Michelle Belcher.
The Hiller's girls currently have no wins, two losses, and two ties. On September 20th, the Hiller's boys took on Holliston. The Panthers netted two second-half goals and took the game 2-0.
Around the defender, out in front, the shot, and that's in! What a shot by Vaquita, 2-0 Holliston.
It was the fourth win in a row and fourth shutout win in a row for undefeated Holliston. Hiller's boys stand at 2 wins, 2 losses on the season. The 1-1 Hiller's varsity football squad took down Medway in their second game of the season by a final of 26-11. Quarterback Jimmy Adams threw for 228 yards and a touchdown. Connor Hebert rushed 10 times for 95 yards and 2 touchdowns, while Isaac Stillwell tallied a rushing touchdown as well for the Hillers, who improved to 1-1 with the victory.
Stillwell to the right of Adams in the shotgun, and to Stillwell, no problem. Touchdown.
This past week, Razor's Edge Salon cut the ribbon for their new location in a brand new plaza at 42 Main Street, and they also celebrated 30 years in business. I talked with owner Lauren Fitzgerald about the new location and the celebration.
Mm-hmm. I'm a professional.
Yay! Razor's Edge Hair Salon hosted a ribbon-cutting ceremony to welcome their new location, 42 Main Street. The salon is also celebrating 30 years in business.
Well, we're celebrating the reopening of the Razor's Edge at the new location. I moved up from 85 Main Street, the old Hopkinton High School, which I've been up there for 27 years. And now I'm down here. More exposure, more foot traffic.
The business moved from 85 Main Street to a new plaza at 42 Main Street.
You know what? It's been great. It's amazing to see what this town has grown up. I've grown up with it, you know, and all the changes and just the new people coming in. Yeah, it's crazy.
So thank you all for coming. To what we are seeing now is a lot more businesses either locating or staying in Hopkinton and relocating to new facilities. So Lauren, thank you very much for, again, your long-term commitment to the town and for, again, deciding to stay and, again, occupy a building downtown. And great success. Congratulations
thank
and
you.
Success for many years to come.
Thank you very much.
Thank you. Just on behalf of the Chamber, we just want to give you a little certificate.
Nice.
And again, congratulations.
Awesome.
Thank you.
Thank you.
Again, I want to congratulate Lauren, Val, and Eileen. You guys have a great team. On behalf of Senator Karen Spilko, she wanted to wish you the best and congratulations on your 30 years. And from State Representative Karen Spilko, she had this citation made up and she asked me to read it. Be it hereby known to all that the Massachusetts House of Representatives offers its sincerest congratulations to Razor's Ridge Salon in recognition of the joyous occasion of celebrating the opening of your new location as well as your 30 years in business in Hopkinton. The entire membership extends its very best wishes and expresses the hope for future good fortune and continued success in all endeavors. Given this, the 16th day of September 2016, signed by Speaker of the House Robert DeLeo and your State Representative Carolyn Dyke.
That's awesome. I'm a professional.
Yay! Great.
Thank you.
Congratulations to Lauren and the staff at Razor's Edge for 30 years of business in the Hopkinton community. On a beautiful Saturday afternoon, many gathered at the town common for the 42nd annual Poly Arts Festival. HKM News was on the scene, and we caught up with a few of the vendors. Many local artists and groups were on hand for the 42nd annual Hopkinton Poly Arts Festival. The packed event took place on a beautiful Saturday afternoon.
Yeah, so I've always really enjoyed doing crafts, so I decided to do some crafts over the summer and then set up a booth at the Poly Arts Festival so we could raise money for Project Just Because, who's like a program for like underprivileged families in the local area, and they help them buy things that they need, like food and clothes.
All right, excellent. What are some of the crafts you got going on here?
So we have coasters and trivets, which are alcohol ink that we did various patterns and we dyed them. We also have emoji pins, which are, they're bigger and they shrink down to like a smaller size, like shrinky dinks, and we painted them to like various emojis. And then we also have string art, which we did in various patterns, and you put nails into a board and you can do it in a whole bunch of patterns and characters. I was kind of just looking for something to like help the community. I really wanted to do some community service, and it was a good way to combine things that like enjoy doing with crafts and helping the community.
So I'm displaying some of my artwork. It's Chinese brush painting. And I've got some of my prints and some originals. I've also taken the originals and made cards. And calendars, I should probably show you the calendar. The calendar has 12 different images, and it's a CD that stands up by itself. And it's applied to different things, coasters and cards and prints. Yeah, this is all done by myself, and it's Chinese brush painting.
Terrific.
Watercolor on rice paper.
Excellent. So is this your first year at Poly Arts?
Yeah, it is my first year. Someone recommended iDaz actually recommended the show, so I signed up, and here I am.
I went to the University of Hartford Art School, and I've been doing art for about 45 years or so, plus when I was a kid. But this is my recent stuff. I was started out as a sculptor, and now I go on to painting, which I started about 10 years ago. Over here, I have my Headless Horseman series, which I've done a lot of prints on, which I'm getting ready for the holidays, Halloween season. And I also do a lot of shows up on the coastal areas, so I do a lot of the seascapes. And more so for Hoppington, I have all this from the Hoppington State Park. And over here with the winter scenes.
Yeah, I sell birdhouses and bird feeders that are handmade and made specifically for various groups of birds, designed with their specifications in mind. I have a good time doing it. They're kind of funky, but we start out with the design requirements and then make them fun and happy after that.
You talk about what town you're from?
I'm right here, right up the street between here and the high school.
All right, is this your first year at Poly Arts?
No, I think I've been here 5 years now, the last 5 years. It's a good show, a lot of fun, a lot of neighbors.
Still to come on HCAM News, Courtney will get you up to date with programming coming up on our channels with the HCAM Insider. We'll take you to the Greyhound Friends annual open house, and Angels Garden Center owner Jeff Doherty has some tips on how to deal with the drought conditions with a new segment called Tips from Angels. A whole lot more ahead. Stay tuned.
HCAM News is supported by our viewers and by Hopkinton Drug, located in this historic New England town since 1954. They are a multifaceted store dedicated to providing clients with an array of healthcare options.
And by Webster First Federal Credit Union, providing financial products with attentive customer service to the local families and businesses of Hopkinton. Visit us at WebsterFirst.com.
Do you have what it takes?
You make a difference?
Always an adventure.
Police and fire working together.
Utilizing the latest technology.
Do you have what it takes?
Welcome back to HCAM News. Throughout the summer, much of the state experienced drought and in some cases, severe drought conditions as rainfall was at a minimum. Despite some recent rain, Hopkinton, as well as many other communities, still face an outdoor watering ban. Owner of Angels Garden Center, Jeff Doherty, has some tips on ways to conserve water and to help you better deal with the drought conditions with his new segment on HCAM News called Tips from Angels.
Hi, my name is Jeff Doherty, and I'm from Angels Garden Center. Many of you have just received a robocall from Fire Chief Slayman and Emergency Director Slayman. In that message, we heard about the drought that has been going on all summer and what that means to us as homeowners and as business owners. One of the things that we need to do is to find new ways to conserve our water and to be able to have our vegetables and our plants still live through a drought. One thing that you can do is something simple that's at every home, and that's the downspout from your gutters, and just take a regular trash barrel and let that fill your trash barrel. That's a 32-gallon trash barrel. It'll fill up with water when we have a rainstorm in 5 to 10 minutes. Then you can take a watering can and dip it in and use that to water whatever you have. Another great method to save water for your plants is actually to use a milk jug. Every time you rinse out a milk jug and you pour it down the sink, you're pouring down liquid fertilizer. And it's as simple as putting about a cup of water in that milk jug and taking it and using it either in the house plants in your home or in the window boxes along the front of your house. These are great methods to do that. And one of those I'll be able to show you if we take a look. It doesn't matter if it's soy, cream, half and half, milk, any one of those would be great to use for your plants. The farmers in Vermont, when they take the milk from the cows and make cheese, they take those milk vats and they rinse them out, they put them into a huge tank that goes on the back of a tractor, and they take it out into the field and spray it all over the field, because that's beneficial nutrients and fertilizer, liquid nitrogen for the grass. And that's why the grass is so green in Vermont. Another great method that you could do, it's kind of too bad that we take fresh drinking water and use that to dispose of our waste. So another water saving technique is to take a regular building brick and put this in the tank of your toilet. This will save about a half a gallon of water. It's a great method to save more water in these times of a drought. One of the more important things that we need to think about as we go forward is all of this media that's about bees and saving bees. Obviously, it has to do with pesticides. But another thing that you can do in your own backyard just to save the bees is to set up either a small pan or a bird bath. Put a little bit of stone in it and fill it with water just to cover the stone, because that way the bees can come down, land on the stone, and then they'll gather the water from inside. And they really need that in the time of a drought. They are doing so much work to gather the pollen so that they can go back to the hive and produce honey. But they're critical to our lifeline, because bees are the ones that pollinate our food, our flowers. That's how they produce honey, but that's how they produce our food. And without the bees, we cannot survive. So hopefully you'll be able to use one of these methods that we've taught you in this time of a drought. Thank you.
Jeff Daugherty will have many other great tips from Angels coming up on future editions of HCAM News. Greyhound Friends hosted their annual open house. The all-weekend event had a great turnout and featured many fun activities for families and pets. Greyhound Friends hosted their annual open house. The all-weekend-long event featured many activities, including a dog show, costume contest, and trick competition.
Well, today is our open house, our annual open house. We have dogs from that have been adopted from here come back, say hi. It's always nice to see them come back, to see them. And we have a silent auction, a raffle. We have a speed run set up in one of our fields to test how fast the greyhounds can run, which is always cool to see. And we just have a big get-together, big, nice greyhound family with food and friends.
It's nice.
It's a different kind of.
He's showing you what he looks like when he flies.
The first place is just hard to repeat this
way. Oh, here it goes.
That is Rollo.
Kevin, good boy.
Good boy.
Yay, Rollo.
I started volunteering here in 2014 for a community service project for my high school, and actually we were supposed to do a project on it, and my project got an award on it, and then I was offered a job here, and I've been working here since the end of 2014. Well, this is Bill. He was a greyhound that we had here not too long ago, and I'm glad to see that he came back today, because I actually kind of missed him. He's such a sweet boy. A lot of people were off put by him, by his bark, but as a lot of people know about dogs, their bark is worse than their bite, and he does not have a bite at all. He's just a sweet boy, and he was looking for a loving home, and I'm really glad to see that he found one. It's just really nice to see them come back after they find their forever home. Okay, well, at Great Home Friends, basically, I am a kennel staff, and I work with all the staff here, and we help pair people with dogs for their home, and we help to hopefully give them lifelong homes. And we help people get acclimated to the new breed of a greyhound if they've never had one before. And it's a nice fulfilling experience pairing people with lifelong partners. And it's always nice to see them go home when they really deserve it. And it's nice to rescue them from track life.
The event was packed, and a good time was had by all humans and hounds. It is a busy September making programs here at HCAM. To fill you in with what to expect on the HCAM channels, here's Courtney Taylor with our HCAM Insider.
Hello everyone, and welcome to the latest edition of the HCAM Insider. On Friday, September 23rd at 8 p.m., Marty Siegel discusses coming to Hopkinton on Hopkinton Coffee Break.
He said, hey, Dad, there's a license available, and it's going to be in a new constructed building, and it's right in the middle of Hopkinton. Hopkinton is great because that everybody knows it across the nation
right. For
being the beginning of the
marathon.
Race. That's right. Mm.
On Saturday, September 24th at 1:30 p.m., the girls' soccer team takes on Norton. At 3 p.m., the football team takes on Medway, and at 5:30 p.m., the boys' soccer team plays against Holliston. On Monday, September 26th, at 5:30 p.m., it's volleyball versus Algonquin Regional, live on HCAM Ed. On Tuesday, September 27th, at 6:30 p.m., Mark Chester and Olga Kwasniewski discuss Mark's photography project and what it is like to come to America. On Thursday, September 29th at 6:30 p.m., Margie Wigan discusses how honesty shaped the lives of community members and students, and why honesty matters in the premiere of Character Matters.
When we make decisions and when we do our day-to-day activities, we're looking at the consequences, the implications for what's going to happen down the line, down the road, years from now.
On Friday, September 30th at 6:30 p.m., the volleyball game against Medway will air live on HCAM Ed. At 9 p.m., Linda Connolly discusses her love of animals, the outdoors, and history, and talks about the importance of libraries on a new Meet Your Neighbor.
Margaret Fahey. And it just was like needle in a haystack, but we found her will at the Historical
wow.
Society.
Oh.
And she had worked in the shoe factories and was probably a very poor woman initially. But she, upon her death, she sent $1,000 back to the little village in her home in Ireland.
On Saturday, October 1st at 7:30 p.m., bank robber Rio swears revenge on his two-timing partner, but falls in love with his partner's daughter when the time for revenge comes in One-Eyed Jacks on Dive-In Drive-In. Mike Prate and Mike Tarosian give behind-the-scenes information.
Movie fans will be interested to know
that Brando was not the first, second, or third choice to direct this film. Brando actually replaced Stanley Kubrick and finished the film.
On Sunday, October 2nd at 10 a.m., the planning board meeting from September 26th will air. To find out more about all of our HCAM shows, head on over to hcam.tv/connect, where you can sign up for our HCAM Insider newsletter. Or if you want to find out about Hopkinton events, you can also sign up for our daily news updates. As always, thanks for watching HCAM. Now back to you, Tom.
Thank you, Courtney. That will just about do it for this edition of HCAM News. Don't forget to stay up to date with everything Hopkinton by checking out our website, hcam.tv, as well as our Twitter and Facebook page. Right now on our website, you can view the latest news on Hiller Sports and also view highlights and read about some of the many recent events in Hopkinton. If there is a photo, video, or story idea you would like to share with us, feel free to email me at news@hcam.tv. With your help, we'll cover even more of our community. For everyone here at HCAM, I'm Tom Nappy. We leave you now with the current community listings and upcoming government meetings. Take care, and thank you for watching HCAM. HCAM is supported by our viewers and by Blackstone Valley Wealth Management, providing highly personalized financial planning, wealth management, and customized solutions through transparent, unbiased advice. Visit us at blackstonevalleywealth.com.
See when the lights start to fade.